a good day to get into bed. Tom Foyt wrote the show, the Horton in the Hearing and Show, and the Kenny Ura Show, Eric, in the sound and the old video. Before I start, I'll just point out to you the emergency, the nightly event of the emergency of any kind. There are two exits, one to your left, that's the air hostess, one to the left, one to your right, behind you, to use. We're delighted to host this celebration of Samhain this afternoon in music and in poetry. And this is a very fruitful event, as you have seen downstairs, in terms of the poems that have been associated with the objects on exhibition. And as you will hear, no doubt, this afternoon, it has been a very fruitful and productive cooperation. And we're delighted to have entered into this partnership with Age&Opportunity and with Poetry Ireland. It's not the first time we've had been partnered with these organisations. And I have no doubt it will not be in the last. So I'm just, on your behalf, to thank our two principal partners, Age and Opportunity, and Poetry Ireland, and also I'd just like to thank on my own behalf the museum staff here, our education and facilities department. So, when you get kind of us in Toronto, enjoy the afternoon, and I now hand over to Catherine Rose, Rector of Age and Opportunity.
Thank you very much, and I'm speaking on behalf of Age and Opportunity, and particularly the Chair of the Board, who is sitting here, John Hines. At Age and Opportunity, we're very passionate about the fact that life should be for living, right through to the end of life, no matter how impaired we may be at the closing stages. And we also are very much believe that that we should go on creating and learning, I suppose, as well, to the end of our lives. We've been somewhat successful, some of you might be aware of the Allman, where we have, I suppose, challenged some of the negative attitudes to ageing through that festival each year. Galton is now, I think, about 18 years old, and very synonymous with, you know, the singing and the dancing and the celebratory side of ageing. So we thought 12 months ago, or longer, because we thought it would be worth exploring the darker elements of ageing, that freight, the bereavement, and so on. And whenever we do a piece of work, we always try to do it in partnership with other organisations, other people. And certainly the partnerships, the three at the moment, I mean, we hope that Samhain will flourish in the years ahead. At the moment, it's partners are the museum, as Ronald said, and Poetry Ireland. And that partnership of the three of us has been enormously fruitful. I mean, the setting here in the museum is wonderful for anything, I suppose, but particularly for the theme, you know, that dark side of things. When we started coming to, I think I said to Lorraine, when we started coming to meetings here first, a couple of us wondered, you know, could we slip our desks in here by any chance into a corner and just be here all the time? It's really wonderful. And also Poetry Ireland, with whom we've collaborated over many years, with Bialdna anyway. And again, bringing the words, I think, along with the artifacts. And then I would like to mention Elaine Agnew, with whom we worked last year, and with whom we're working again this year. And again, Elaine, we really chose well, I think, in working with you. Thank you. I forget that I need to put on the specs. having succeeded in making Bialdna synonymous with aging and celebration, and convinced of the importance of creativity in our lives as we aged. As I say, we put the spotlight on the darker side. Choosing Samhain because it's a time of year that's already, I suppose, associated with the beginning of the darker half of the year. Really just want to finish up by mentioning an author, Rumour Gordon, in one of her books talks about an Indian proverb that says that everyone is a house with four rooms, a physical, mental, emotional and spiritual room. And she points out that most of us tend to live only in one room most of the time. But says that unless we go into every room every day, even if it's only to keep it aired, then we're not a complete person. And I think that's valuable for us around the marking of Samhain. I would like to mention workshop participants with whom Elaine has worked. I was lucky enough to be there for a part of one workshop, and I could just feel the atmosphere, which was really, really wonderful. And I know some of the workshop participants were with Elaine last year, some are new. Really looking forward to hearing them. Just want to say one last thing. I want to borrow from the title of this book, which isn't a great book, so I'm not actually to recommend that you go out and buy it. But I absolutely love the title, and the title is The Warmth of the Heart Prevents Your Body from Rusting. So I just want to wish us all that the warmth of our hearts today and for the rest of this season will prevent our bodies from rusting. Just introducing you now to a colleague, Carroll, whose responsibility for Age&Opportunity Samhain is, and the Allman indeed.
As we're in the archaeology department of the museum, I'm going to show you something very old. This is my very ancient mobile phone. So it's just a reminder that if you haven't already switched off your phone, please do. And it's my pleasure to introduce you to somebody rather famous and well-known, a very well-known actress who is currently showing in a film called Filomena, which is on the screens at the moment, and has already been in one of my favorite films, which is The Snapper, and also my left foot, Ruth McCain.
And of course, now, Domain Filomena is a tiny, tiny little part of it. You're blinking, you miss it, but it's a fantastic film. It's really good. Now, I'm going to reinforce this. The phone, we're all perfectly delighted to pay fines where cars are parked in the wrong place. So I think if your phone goes off during something, really you should be fined as well, but seeing as we're not. So, now the next people up are Robbie Blake and the Tonto Choir, which means waves. I tell you, I heard them yesterday, it's just fantastic. So come on lads, let's go.
Thank you. Demon,
other arts cannot reach, eh? I'm just the human heart. Actually, today is the 6th, 30 days as November. So that means we have 43 to go, is the shortest day. So just put your heads down, think about that. Thinking about the times light was referred to in that fantastic, incredible music. Now the next group up are a workshop that have worked on stuff in the museum and are doing their own work now in response to that. And the museum is, what is this, the human family, generations after generations after generations. Couldn't make it up, folks. You couldn't make it up. Okay, we need more.
Love, antiquate. Holds 100,000 sips. Warmth and healing to the lips.
Intricately woven, like lace in solid gold. Well, welcome, Jeff Cotsfield. It's history to unfold.
Three faces look out to smell and watch. Look in to see and hear, to feel and touch.
Oars at the ready, mast aloft, tiny golden boat, the wind is soft.
Where will she sail this tiny boat upon? To lands far off, to the casks of fairy wine.
What is that sound? I've never heard before. I listen, louder now, and nearer to the shore.
I'm filled with fear. What makes that sound? I spill my cup of water. I hear the dreadful sound again. Run to find my daughter.
Faintly at first, I hear it. Then nearer, louder, calling. Answered by another sound. The frightened cat bawling.
This smooth stone, resting in my palm, was once an axe head for some ancient man.
Round bowl, deep and full of mystery, dark inside, dark as ours.
Golden bones from ancient plunder speak only now in silent wonder.
Come, sail away with me and float with joy for the world.
This tight restraint must grip with pain. Was it to tame the mighty Dane? In the next millennium, will they have a house called a museum, where long ago is shown in objects? Will they be fascinated, looked into a glass case, peer at a painted statue of a virgin and her son, a walkman, shown some rough shotgun, and wonder who wore the red patent shoes the killer used? Miry headed winds, dragged the mouth, tell me where's all that fury now?
Two-headed man, one alone could not hold his wild imaginings, his plans so brave, so bold.
The bitter of antiquity seeks a left to room, brings success to a warrior's room that leads to this.
A bell would summon the faithful of every age, now holds its tongue, is now without a language.
Bacon's bowls resembles heart. Breakspear broke for Iron's heart. The pious hand that crafted the page turned to invasion, division, and rage.
Beware! Steady, stony, stare, hear, hear, everywhere. Hypnotized by beady eyes, you sear my being. There is no shame. Enigmatic, brooding eyes. Slit mouth of tricephalic rage. King Tyrannus and army dies, just your bloodlust to assuage. All the mists of time, silently whisper. slowly fading to Allman's continuum.
Metro nails of the Iron Age, well preserved, not for you, the monarch of Bobman. Hidden in the dark, damp